Let's see one more interesting program. Here SAM23 is a two-dimensional array, and this is a dynamic memory allocation. So I am allocating 2 × 3, that is for 6 element of integers type. So I am allocating space for 6 integer type of element, that is 12 bytes, okay, by using function calloc. So we have initialized, we have allocated 12 bytes, and we have initialized all the 6 element by the value 0, because we have used the function calloc for allocating the space. Okay, now we know this if statement. Now you see, the next part is very interesting. Here PTR is equal to SAM. SAM is a two-dimensional array. I have allocated memory by using function calloc, and now to this PTR, which point to the allocated memory in heap area, I am assigning SAM, the base address of SAM. And after that, in the for loop, I want initialization as well as I want to display the array SAM. Here initialization is very typical type of initialization. Here k is equal to 10, and here I am incrementing the k. So PTR 00 will contain 10, then PTR 01 will contain 20, and so on. So 6 array elements are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. Okay, so let us compile this program. Press F9. What happened? There are warnings and error message. Two warning and two error message. Let us see suspicious pointer conversion in function main. So this pointer conversion has created some problem. What is that? Let us see. Here the dynamic memory allocation creates storage for 6 integer elements. You see, here in the function calloc we have created space for 6 integer type of element. Okay, now but we cannot use two-dimensional array reference to access it. Okay, that is SAM5 will be the last element of the array and not SAM12, because we have allocated the memory for 6 element, not for the 2-dimensional array. Okay, so you see, we can correct this problem. Just select next program. Here is the modified and correct version of the previous program. What I have done is that I have declared a 1-dimensional array, SAM6. Again, calloc function is allocating memory for 6 integer type of element, and it will return, calloc function will return the starting address of this allocated memory to the PTR. And now you see, here I am assigning SAM, base address of SAM, to the PTR. Now here in the for loop, what I am doing is that I am using single for loop, and I am using PTRI. Okay, so this is for one dimensional array. Now if I compile the program, then there will be no warning and error message. You see, if you compile this program, there are warning free as well as error free. Okay, now if you execute this one, we'll find that the for loop has displayed all the 6 values, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and 60. Is it clear? Thank you.